Hey everyone, Knowledge here with Reach Your Summit. Thanks for joining me. This is going to be another one of my Allegheny 100 gear videos for some items I'm going to be personally bringing with me on this year's Allegheny 100 challenge. This video, I'm going to go over what a lot of hikers refer to as the big three, or what I like to call the big four. Those items are a backpack, shelter, and sleep system, whether it's a sleeping bag or a quilt, or a sleeping pad or an underquilt. So let's get right into it. So for this year, I'm going to be going with a hammock system. During the first year that I participated in the challenge, I ended up using a tarp and bivy. It was very uncomfortable. It's not for everyone, but I was trying to go as light as possible. And then last year, I wanted to increase my comfort a little bit, so I ended up bringing out a trekking pole tent. So this year, I opted for a hammock system just because it's going to allow me to set up pretty much anywhere I need to when I'm feeling really tired. And I don't have to stress about looking for specific flat spots at night when I'm setting up. That was something that I ran into on the last 2 years that I participated in the challenge with the tarp and bivy and with the tent. I also personally sleep a lot more comfortably inside of a hammock than I do in a tent or a tarp and bivy. So for this challenge this year, I'm going to be using the Dream Hammock Darien. This is one of the most comfortable hammocks that I've ever slept in. I've used it on multiple trips now, and I'm very confident that I'll get a good night's rest inside of this hammock. Hopefully, I will want to get up and wake up the next morning to continue the challenge. This is that comfortable for me. The hammock uses a 1.3 Mountain XL. And it does have the bug net integrated in the hammock, so I will get good bug protection in the middle of June in Allegheny National Forest. I don't have to worry about any bugs. The suspension system that I'm going to be using to set up the hammock is a pair of Dutchwear Spider Poly 12-foot long straps with beetle buckles on one end and the Jeff Myers Tech Hammock Labs Evo Loops made out of 7/64 AM steel in my favorite color, blue. This system is nice and light. I don't have to worry about anything snagging inside of my pack. And it's just a really nice, quick, efficient system. This is what I'm going to be going with overall. And my Dream Hammock Darien is inside of a double-ended light AF Dyneema composite fabric hammock stuff sack also. Now the hammock does have a couple of tie-outs, so I will be utilizing those just to increase the head box and the foot box of the asymmetrical hammock. So I'm going to have a couple of MSR groundhog stakes, and I'll show you those in just a second. That's going to be my complete system if the weather looks to be nice and dry throughout the entire weekend. I will make that decision as I get very close to the event itself. Right now, I'm anticipating some rain, because the last couple of years it has rained when I've been out there. It's very wet. It can get very cool at night around the low 50s. Depending on where you're setting up, you might get some nice cool air, especially with a hammock. You're going to have a little more increased ventilation than you would with a closed in tent. So for the hammock, for wind protection, for rain protection, for a slight increase in warmth should I need it. I am also planning on bringing my Light AF Dyneema composite fabric tarp. This is an 11-foot hammock tarp with doors, and this has worked really well. I've had it out in winds, I've had it out in rain, and I've had it out in snow, and I haven't had any major issues with it yet. I really, really like this tarp, and I'm looking forward to getting more use out of it. This is wrapped in a hammock gear mesh snake skin, So it'll allow me to set this up very quickly and easily and pack it up very efficiently also. So I'm anticipating bringing this with me. If I don't need it as I get closer to the event, then I will leave it at home. If I do end up using this, I am also going to have my tent steaks. My tent steaks are MSR groundhog steaks. I have four of them, and I have some blue zingit line and some Dutchware hookworms that are attached to it. And this allows me to just unravel the line off of the steak and stake out my tarp very quickly. If I don't end up using the tarp, these are the stakes that I'm going to use to stake out the hammock. I only need the four for the tarp when I am using the complete system, and the hammock does clip right to the same stake and line that the tarp is using, so I don't need to carry any extra stakes. And my stakes and line are inside of a Light AF Dyneema composite fabric tent stake bag. This tarp does also use Myers Tech Hammock Labs Dyneema continuous ridge line, so it'll be very quick and easy to set up with that also. Now, because I'm using a hammock, I'm going to be going with quilts for my insulation. I'm not going to be using a sleeping pad. I personally find underquilts to be a lot more comfortable than a sleeping pad. And the temperatures being around the mid to low 50s at night is going to allow me to go a little bit lighter with my insulation. So even if I don't use the hammock tarp and I don't need it, I'm still going to be going with this insulation that I'm about to show you. So my under quilt that I'm choosing to use is a custom made Hammock Gear 40 degree Phoenix under quilt. This is 3/4 length, so it's not full length, but it's still very comfortable and very warm. I've used this out down to about the mid 30s and I've still been very comfortable with it. This will also allow me to go a little bit lighter in weight and take up a little less pack space inside of my pack. I'm just going to be sleeping very minimally for a couple of nights while I'm out on this challenge. So I don't want to bring extra bulk or extra weight if I don't really need it. I'm very confident that I'll get a good night's rest with this wrapped around the outside of my hammock. And I'll be storing that 40 degree underquilt in a Hyperlite Mountain Gear Dyneema composite fabric stuff sack. In the last couple of years, I used sleeping bags and quilts. So the first year I ended up using the Sierra Designs Cloud 35. It's kind of a blend between a quilt and a sleeping bag, a mummy style sleeping bag. Last year, I ended up using the Enlightened Equipment Revelation 20. Both of those worked very well, but still it was a little unnecessary for the time of year, and I typically sleep warm. So I'm going to be using a double black diamond top quilt. This is just your standard quilt. This has 700 fill duck down. And I picked up a couple of these at Costco a few years ago. It's like $30 for two and free shipping. And this is a great warm weather top quilt for me. I sleep very comfortably down to about 40, 45 degrees with this before I need to start layering everything else on. So with this and my sleepwear that I had mentioned in my clothing video, I'm confident I'll be very comfortable in this. This barely weighs anything. It packs up very small. I've been pretty happy with it overall over the last few years that I have used it in warm weather trips. And I'll be storing that in a separate Hyperlite Mountain Gear Dyneema composite fabric stuff sack in the same size. With my two quilts, I'm also going with something else for a little bit of comfort. Even though I'm using a hammock, I still prefer to use a sleeping pillow. The last couple of years, I used a pillow. I used the Sea to Summit Eros Ultralight the first year. And last year, I ended up using the pillow that I'm about to show you. I've been very happy with it. And for a couple of extra ounces, it's well worth the wait to get a good night's rest, in my opinion. With that, I'm going to be using the Sea to Summit Eros Down Pillow. This is a large pillow. It's larger than the regular size. So I'm getting additional width and additional length as well. This has 600 fill duck down inside of it, and it's air inflated, so I can adjust the amount of firmness that I want in the pillow. This has been one of my luxury items that I've been very happy with over the many, many trips that I've used it on so far. And I'm not going back to anything else anytime soon. And this will be getting stored with my Hammock Gear Phoenix underquilt in that same stuff sack. Now, the pack that I'm going to be using, I'll get into in just a minute. It is a frameless pack. Regardless of the type of pack that I use, I always carry a Therm-a-Rest Z-Seat pad, and I'm going to be using this year. Not just for my pack and pack support, but also as the additional piece of insulation for my hammock system. So because that Hammock Gear Phoenix is 3/4 length, I'm going to have the pad right underneath my feet inside of the hammock. And this will give me that additional barrier from the cold and keep my feet warm and comfortable while I'm laying down inside of the hammock. I can also use this to sit down and take breaks if I need to. And as I just mentioned, it's also going to give my pack a little bit of extra cushion and comfort and a small amount of support. So my pack choice for this year's challenge is going to be a frameless pack, as I had just said. The first year that I did this challenge, I ended up using the Osprey Levity 45. And last year I used the Hyperlite Mountain Gear Southwest 3400. I had it packed down to the smaller 2400 or 40 liters just because I didn't end up using a lot of that pack space. Those two packs do have hip belts, and I've been kind of drifting away from using hip belts with my Atom Packs Atom 40. I found that to be a lot more comfortable with the base weight that I was carrying in most cases. And so for this challenge this year, I'm going to be using a hip beltless, frameless, custom made Superior Wilderness Designs Superior 35. This pack is made out of Dyneema composite fabric. I'm a big fan of Dyneema, and this pack has been super comfortable on the trips that I've used it on so far. I'm looking forward to getting a lot more in with it before the Allegheny 100, whether it's day hikes or hopefully trips once things start getting a little better for all of us out there. And I'll put a link in the video description for this specific pack. I just put a video up recently going over it a bit more in detail. 35 liters is plenty of space for a weekend for me, and with what my gear is like now, I would definitely consider something like this for a through hike even, as my gear gets a little bit lighter and more packable. Inside of the pack, I do also have a pack liner that I will be using. And that pack liner is going to be a Nyloflume pack liner bag. This is going to give some of my items even higher water resistance. I already have it with the Dyneema composite fabric. I also have it with the Dyneema composite fabric stuff sacks. So this will just give me a little extra security with the things that I'm carrying inside of the pack. I don't like using rain covers. I've had issues with them in the past, and I've used trash compactor bags. Those would be my next choice. I've had great luck with the Nyloflume, but I've also had a great experience with trash compactor bags, their durability. They're going to be a little more durable than the Nyloflume, but I am pretty careful with my gear, so I'm going to end up using the Nyloflume for this challenge. So that is the big four that I will be using for this year's Allegheny 100 challenge. If you have any questions on any of the gear that I showed in this video, please feel free to get in touch with me in a comment below, or you can also contact me at reachyoursummit.net. If you have any questions on the event itself, you can also contact me with either one of those methods. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing to my channel, as I'm always adding new content to it, and I look forward to sharing a lot more of that with you in the near future. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, I'll see you on the trail.